Hey guys, it is Damak and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we're here for episode 5 of my Bournemouth Career Mode. The first match today is at Vicarage Road as we face Watford in the Premier League. If you did miss last episode, it wasn't a good one for ourselves. Two losses on the trot. One was against Fulham in the Carabao Cup and the other was against Crystal Palace, who pulled off a comeback from being 1-0 down at home as well. So Watford are in 18th right now, the lowest scoring team, with 4 goals this season. The Bournemouth lineup today: Begovic starting goals with Smith, Cook, Ake and Rico, the back four. The midfield consists of Ibe, Lermak, Cook and Fraser. And up top, Josh King and Callum Wilson. As we're getting underway for the first match of episode 5, it's Gray kicking us off. And let's get underway. Jefferson Lerma there in the middle of the park has played so well for us so far. As Fraser plays the ball down into Rico. He's made another run. He's not as quick as Firmino. He cuts inside of Firmino though. Rico's there. He has a shot. It's blocked by the defender for Watford. It falls to Cook. Lewis Cook finds Fraser, who leans it back into Lerma from the edge of the box. Hits one. It's just past the post though. And that is an early chance there for ourselves. Jefferson Lerma has played so well the last few matches, although we've lost. He hits one there, it's just past Foster's post. Sema beats his man, he's now got Smith chasing him back into the box. Nathan Ake can clear, and so can Lewis Cook. We can't get the ball away, and Begovic can catch that. Into Jefferson Lerma now. Lerma can play a ball through, he has done so. I think he's offside, as Josh King, he is indeed. He slots it in the back of the net. He's offside though, on the stroke of half time. Just too late there for Lerma. Yeah, he's way too late. Ducore can find Delafeu. Delafeu into Gray. The ball's been played through into Okaka. And Watford, even though they've scored the least goals this season, Okaka has put them in the lead. They're 1-0 up in the 56th minute. That's just what we want. Away from home, we could possibly be 3 losses on the trot in all competitions after this. We really need to make a comeback. Colin Wilson's holding the ball up. He can find Lewis Cook. Inside from Cook into Josh King. Josh King can play it wide to Jordan Ibe. First touch. And Foster makes a fantastic save there to push it out for a corner kick. Capu now into Deeney. Troy Deeney beats a defence. Begovic is out to punch away. It falls to Capu once again. Sema there on the volley. It's blocked by Lerma. It's out for another corner kick. And that was so close to being 2-0 to Watford, as Begovic was not in goals. So we're bringing off Cook and Fraser. And on come Brooks and Moussa for the final 17 odd minutes. We need a goal, so we're going to try and get one. Delafeu whips in the ball. It only falls to Lerma, who can clear as far as Vallejo. Ducore now to Delafeu. Delafeu whips it in, and Deeney's there, and we've gone 2-0 down. Absolute shambles here at Vicarage Road. Watford have gone 2-0 up, and from 18th in the table, they're finding their feet once again. Watford have gone 2-0 up. Jordan Ibe whips it into the box. Who's there? Moussa on the header. Foster can save. 10 minutes remaining, and I don't think we're going to do this. And we've lost 2-0, surely. Yes, we have. The game ends Watford 2, Bournemouth 0, as that is such a devastating result for ourselves. Watford being the lowest scoring team in the league, I thought we could have something, but today, maybe it's a change around for Watford. I don't know. We just struggled so much. And I'm a bit disappointed with that, but on we go. We can't lose the next match though. The next match is a must win to keep our managerial career alive, really, at this club. So we had more shots and shots on target than Watford. We were just unable to convert them into goals. So he has rejected both of them. Brooks is now injured for 6 weeks. So that's something we've got to watch out for. We've got another loan offer for this guy. I don't even know where that club's from, but we're going to accept it again. We just go. You're going to get more playtime there. That's what you need to do. Oh my, there's another club wanting him. we're going to accept that club as well. He needs to go one of them. He needs more game time. And unfortunately, I can't give it to him at the way we're playing just now. So our next match is in the Premier League once again. It is against Southampton, who are currently in 10th, 1 point behind us. We're in 8th, and hopefully we can do something today at the Vitality Stadium. Let's head into this match. Hopefully we can win and end our losing streak. Welcome back to the Vitality Stadium. Its first appearance in this episode as we're facing Southampton today. Now, I've said this in all the build-ups to the following, the last three games, but we need to win this desperately. The fans will turn on me if we don't win this, because it'll be, what, four losses in a row, which is absolutely unacceptable for any manager. And since we got off to such a good start, as you can see, we're in eighth. For ourselves, Begovic starts in goals with Smith, Cook, Ake and Mings, the back four. In the midfield, we have Ibe, Lerma, Brooks and Fraser. And King and Wilson are starting up top once again. The main two up top. We've made two changes from the last game. The Southampton lineup today. Forster is in goals with Yankee, Vestergaard, Hoyt and Bertrand. The back four. Redmond, Lamina, Romeo and El Yunusi are in the midfield. And Gabbiadini and Finn Bogason are up top. Anyway, it is going to be Josh King kicking us off for the second match of this episode. Episode 5 of the Career Mode. We need to win this, we need to get a draw at least. I'll be happy with some points out of this game. And the main two need to step up with their goal drought lately. It's just been frustrating. They need to pick up the game as the ball has come through into Jordan Ibe. He's been shoved off by Bertrand. And it's quite a positive start to the game, but we need to defend as well. Can find Josh King. Josh King plays a lovely ball far side into Ryan Fraser. Down this left hand side. Ryan Fraser into the box. Who's there? Callum Wilson! And straight off the bat, we have a goal. 6 minutes in and Callum Wilson ends that goal drought. And he puts us 1-0 up against Southampton. We've got 83 minutes left on the clock. Or 83 and a half. So we need to keep this. It's a long time to keep a lead. As Callum Wilson with a wonderful header past Fraser Forster in the Southampton net. The home fans are finally quite happy for once in the last few matches. And let's get underway once again. Wilson with the goal. Can now pressurise the defence of Southampton. Now Josh King is doing it. He's away from the defence. Into the box from Josh King. Onto the... Oh my word. Oh my word, Ryan Fraser. I cannot believe that. All he had to do was tap it in. But he volleys it over the bar. He tried to be cocky on a wind drought. And he's just skied it. That could have been game, set, match there. 15 minutes in, but no. Ball's down into El Yunusi. Romeo down the far side into El Yunusi now. The ball's up the pitch into Gabbiadini. He takes a touchy... Oh my word, Begovic. Begovic has just let one in from Gabbiadini. And I don't understand. Fraser should have scored a minute ago. And now Begovic is putting it into his own net for Gabbiadini. I just don't understand. Let's look at this once again. So Gabbiadini picked up the ball. He hits it. Begovic just dived the wrong way. Let's look at this again. Begovic, he could have just stayed there, but no, he dived it away, palmed it into his own net, and that's just a letdown there. We had the lead for 13 minutes, and now we're back to all square once again in this match against Southampton. Jordan Ibe can play a ball through. It's into Josh King now. Josh King back pulls once again, and it's not gone in once again. Yeah, so we've just got to clear the ball. Gabbiadini once again. Into Romeo. Gabbiadini's found some space. He plays it in. Smith pops over the bar. Lovely defending there from Smith to put it over the bar. And Brooks can find Wilson. And now Josh King. Josh King can find Lerma in the middle of the park. Lerma plays a ball through into Josh King. Josh King's away on the edge of the box. King! Oh, what a lovely strike. What a lovely, lovely strike there from Josh King. He's put us 2-1 up in this match. And I'm so happy. My voice is just gone, really, but 2-1 up. Josh King there, scoring the goal for ourselves. He just went into the box. Defenders were closing him, so he had a hit. Forster got a hand to it, but it went top bins due to that deflection from Forster, and that's so good for ourselves. It's 2-1 now to Bournemouth, and hopefully we can see off the rest of this game with 28 minutes remaining. Now it's into Lerma. with a lovely ball far side into Jordan Ibe. He actually takes it in well. He's away down the right-hand side as Jordan Ibe. He plays the ball through into Josh King. He tries to slide it past Forrester, but it doesn't work out. And once again, another chance goes looming for Bournemouth. We're looking a lot more lively now than we were. Lerman plays it out to Smith after that free kick. Into the box from Smith. King tries an acrobatic. It doesn't reach anyone but Mings. Mings tries to whip it in, but there's nobody on the end of it. And he should have just had a shot from that range as Wilson can find Lerma. Josh King now into Cook. Cook plays the ball through into Lerma. Lerma's away the centre defensive mid. Jefferson Lerma hits the bar from a chance. Wilson has a shot now and Davis can deflect that out for a corner kick. The ball's going to come in from the corner for Stanislas. It's onto the head of Lerma, straight at Fraser Forster. And surely that's the end of the game. The ref has blown and our losing drought is over as we win 2-1 against Southampton at home. I am delighted with that. At the start of the episode, I wasn't so happy because we just lost that game and we didn't deserve to. We were so high up the league. We played so much better. But today, we proved that we can win a game once again. And the fans surely will be back behind me as we go through the rest of the season. Hopefully they don't have their doubts about me now as we win 2-1 against Southampton at home. We had so many chances though that actually were clinical, like that Josh King one and the Callum Wilson one. We should have put them to bed, so we should have had 4 goals at least, but we didn't. So it ends 2-1 here today with 11 shots to 6 and 7 on target to 3, so we did deserve that match. And if we didn't win it, I would have been quite frustrated. Josh King gets the man of the match with a 9.5 rating. The goal's coming from King and Wilson themselves. And the goal for Southampton coming from Gabbiadini. Our keeper Begovic made 4 saves today, whereas Fraser Forster made 7 in the Southampton net, which therefore kept them in the game. But thankfully, we get a win under our belt once again this season. And it is another 3 points in the league. So our next match is away at Fulham. This will be in the next episode in the Premier League once again. Let's look at the standings after another game. 2 games, sorry. Spurs lead the way alongside Chelsea and Man City. The top 3 still unbeaten, the 3 of them. Crystal Palace sit in 4th. Ourselves are in 5th. Joint on points with Palace. We're just behind on goal difference. We've just scored 1 more goal. We've got a 1 goal difference, sorry. Our next opponent's Fulham. We lost them in the Carabao Cup 3 games ago, or 4 games ago, sorry. And they're sitting in 12th place on 11 points. So surely, well, I said this with Watford, surely we'll beat them, but that never happened. So it's going to be a tough game once again. Also, I've added all of your suggestions into the shortlist for players that I should get in the January transfer window. If you know any players that you want me to get in the transfer window, let me know in the comments below. I'm open to suggestions. One of them said to get mostly British players because that's what Bournemouth do, but some of them are quite interesting in this list, so let me know down in the comments below what you want me to do. So thank you guys for watching this episode. Please leave a like and subscribe for more Bournemouth Career Mode if you enjoyed it. Let me know down in the comments below, as I just said, who to sign in the January transfer window and also how to improve the series for your viewing. Have a wonderful day guys, and I'll see you guys next time.